Hey guys, quick announcement before I dive in today. I'm launching a podcast with Rachel Oates and Rationality Rules called the Here and How Podcast, where we'll be exploring our past and how we got here and diving into big ideas so that we can create a brighter future together. I'll have a link in the video description. Go check it out. Thanks.
If there is something to the paranormal, let's find out what it is, if anything. And on the other hand, let's not be taken in by the claptrap that is being offered us and at our expense.
Psychic powers. Whether it's telekinesis, psychic healing, astral projection, seeing auras, or detecting water, or even talking with the dead.
I see dead people.
People claiming to have supernatural powers are all around us. But is there any merit to these types of claims? And can you test them scientifically to know for sure? Most psychics agree that their powers can be tested.
Before we started filming, Joe agreed in principle to undertake a scientific test.
Are you willing to take his test?
Yeah, whatever test it is.
But you'd be willing to do that, right?
Yes, I would be willing to do that.
Do you think you could have the million dollars?
Oh, absolutely.
Even if scientists couldn't detect any kind of psychic energy field with their current instruments, we would at least be able to measure the effects that this field has on the physical world. Effects like psychic healing tested against a placebo, telekinesis of objects inside of an airtight container, clairvoyance, and precognition of unlikely events outside of the psychic's control. If psychic waves of energy actually healed people, moved objects, or allowed for remote viewing, that's something we can test. Let's examine a few ways that this can and has been done. Claim 1. Seeing auras. A psychic claims that they can see other people's unique auras, even glowing through walls. You work with the psychic to devise an experiment that you both agree upon to test that claim. You find an opaque wall that they claim that they can see people's unique auras through. Have an unbiased third party randomly place people behind the wall in a specific order. Then have those people come forward and have the psychic place them in the correct order based on their auras.
If, as you claim, you can see auras through the screen, John should now be standing in the same position as he was when he was behind the screen. Is that correct?
Yes.
If they're actually psychic, they should consistently score significantly higher than chance, and ideally would get it 100% every single time. Claim 2. Water divining. A group of water dowsers claims that they can psychically detect the location of water using various types of dowsing rods. You work with them to devise an experiment to test it that they're happy with. You bury 10 pipes a meter apart. See-through holes at the end allow third-party, unbiased judges to make sure that water is or isn't flowing through them. The water diviners examine the entire mechanism, test it to make sure that it's clear of any interference prior to running water through the pipes, and any prior objections that they have are listened to and accommodated for.
One does get a residual effect for some time afterwards. I would not be certain in my own mind whether it was moisture within the pipe or a possible magnetic effect caused by the initial flowing of the water.
Okay. Now, we have attempted to get around that. That's always a possibility, of course. The site that you'll see up there is built on a slope. There are a couple of feet from one end to the other. The water is being gravity-fed. It's being brought in from a hydrant. It goes into a drum, and from the drum, it flows into the pipe. So it's not being directly pumped through. It's not being forced through in gushes like that. Not only that, when the valves are opened up, all of the pipes drain out because they are running downhill.
Water is then run through one of the pipes with the dowser's knowledge to make sure that they can, or at least think that they can, psychically detect it.
Are you satisfied with the conditions?
They appear to be quite okay, Bob, yes.
That seems pretty fair to me.
Everything that we have asked for so far has been met with, and I think this is fair enough.
You then start randomly selecting one pipe at a time to run water through, and the psychics, using nothing but their dowsing rods, have to determine which pipe the water is flowing through. Now perform this test multiple times. You can perform a similar test by placing gold or any other substance they claim they can detect in a random box. In both cases, the water dowser's hits should be considerably higher than what you would expect from random guesses and chance alone. Claim 3. Talking with the dead. Someone claims that they can talk with the dead. This type of claim is harder to test, due to the large number of clues given away in a cold reading. One method would be to place someone on one side of an opaque curtain with the psychic on the other side, so that the psychic can't pick up on things like their gender, age, ethnicity, marital status, etc. For the sitter, choose someone from Ireland where names are impossible to spell or pronounce like Teague or O'Sheen. Or better yet, Zimbabwe, where parents traditionally give their kids very unusual English names like Polling Station Namoinesu, Trimor Simangu, and Released Results Matongo. I kid you not, those are actual names in Zimbabwe. Record the reading, but don't allow the sitter to respond or give any kind of feedback. Then analyze the reading afterwards and compare it to the results you would expect to get by chance. If they're psychic, their hits should far exceed their misses, and rather than guessing common English names like James, John, or Mary, they'll come up with Ballot Box Mahosi, Have a Look Dube, Evin, or Limited Chikafa. Claim 4. Psychic Healing. Procure a large sample of individuals suffering from a non-lethal ailment that the psychic claims she can cure supernaturally. Divide your sample into three groups. The first is a control group and won't receive any treatment. The second will receive the psychic healing procedure. Make sure that the psychic keeps a distance of at least a foot or two to prevent them from secretly administering any kind of medication. If they insist on touching the patient, search them prior to the procedure and have them thoroughly wash and disinfect their hands. The third group receives the placebo. They're also told that they're receiving a psychic healing treatment, but instead of a psychic, have an actor in a long white robe wave spirit fingers over the patient while thinking about Toy Story 2. Make sure that the experiment is performed double-blind, in other words, every patient assumes that they're being seen by an actual psychic, and the doctors administering the test are kept in the dark as to which one is the actor. Now just measure the recovery rates of all three groups. If the psychic healer actually has psychic powers, there should be a statistically significant difference in recovery rates between the healer and the actor, well outside the margin of error, and it should be higher than the control group. Now, either these exact tests or similar ones to them have been performed hundreds of times over the last 50 years by the James Randi Educational Foundation and have never yielded a single positive result favoring psychic claims.
I mean, 111 tries were undertaken. There were a total of 15 successful, and that makes approximately a percentage of 12%. So the result was just a little over the 10%.
It's equivalent to throwing a dart at random into a dartboard or flipping coins or choosing cards at random.
Please reveal which position you were originally standing in by showing us. I think it's inside your hat, isn't it? Take them off and let's see. C, B, D, A, and E. So out of this, we obtained 2 correct. All right. So James, you got 2 out of 5 correct, and I take my hat off to you for trying.
And yet you still have psychics claiming to have passed rigorous scientific testing. How is that possible? In an ideal world, testing people's claims of psychic power should be as easy as performing a clinical trial. Anyone should be able to do it. And for many claims, it is. A great number of self-proclaimed psychics truly believe that they have supernatural powers and sincerely wish to demonstrate them. For them, an honest scientific test like the ones above should be sufficient. But the downside to testing psychic claims in a lab is that scientists aren't usually trained in dealing with deception, and some psychics actually are skilled liars or magicians and can be pretty deceptive. Most lab technicians aren't used to their subjects trying to manipulate them. Lab rats don't cheat, but humans aren't lab rats, and humans do. In my next video, we'll cover a few instances in which psychics managed to fool scientists in a lab, and we'll talk about some of the ways to safeguard against psychic trickery when running tests like this. If you enjoyed this video and the work that I do spreading scientific skepticism and critical thinking, please consider supporting my work with a few bucks on Patreon, or check out my merchandise store to help me continue regularly making great content for you. You guys rock, as always. Dare to be curious, but don't drink the Koolaid.